y'all don't mind, let's go back to a time we really used to have church. We used to have a good time, praising the Lord, in spirit and in truth.
I love them old
church. That old brother, pick up that old hymn book and
singing,
you knew exactly what he was gonna say. Sisters got happy.
I love them old church.
Folks start patting their feet, clapping their hands, and all of a sudden, he break off in a song, something like this.
In a person's plan for success, if he or she has lived their life in a length of time and has not stopped just for a moment and considered Christ. This Christ that we serve speaks of what life is with him. But he also speaks through his word what life is without him. The text says that life with me is like being connected to a vine. I am the conduit between life and death, the body system of a vine to a plant. The plant receives its nourishment through the vine. And if you were to detach from the vine, life would not be as it were. Christ is the lifeline between man and God. He says in his word in John chapter 10 that I am the door, and that no man coming to the Father except by me. And just that vine statement alone, it would eliminate Ignatius' argument, which the Catholic Church declared that Jesus Christ was not the Son of God, the very nature of God, because he was in the flesh.
Amen.
And from a ruling at that standpoint in history, the Catholics can never take it away. They denied that Jesus Christ is the Son of God.
Well,
and ruled that he was just a good man. But not only that, the Muslim faith, shunning otherwise, declared themselves that Jesus was not divine, that he was just a good prophet, another man.
Well,
but not only that, the Jehovah's Witness clearly identified in their teaching that Jesus Christ is just a good prophet. Mormonism teaches that Joseph Smith, whatever their founder name is more in tune with God than Christ.
Well,
and say that they have another prophet just as good as Jesus Christ. Oh, I could go on and on from one fallacy to another. But the most important statement made of all is from Jesus himself. Jesus says, I am divine. I don't know about the rest of them who are claiming to be divine, but Jesus said, I am divine.
Man, that's
what he said. And I like that because if you don't get that part, they can do whatever they want to be, but you need to understand what divine is. Amen.
Man.
And folk who don't understand who divine is will have a life that is missing its ability to have the life that Christ has. Christ says in John 10, verse number 10, they said that I have come, the thief come, but to steal, kill, and destroy. But I come that ye may have life and have life how?
More abundant.
More abundant. Divine connects you to an abundant life.
Yes, sir.
And when you are disconnected from the vine, then your lifestyle will soon fall.
Y'all like man.
And
man.
So when I look at my life,
yes,
and folk who claim to be divine, I look back at Mormonism and say that that vine one day told me that I didn't have the same spirit as a white man. And that vine told me I couldn't be a priest in his church. But when I look at what Jesus said, abide in me, and I will abide in you, and you can do whatever you want to do.
Amen.
But if you get disconnected from me, you will start to sound like an atheist. Mm. If you get disconnected from me, you will speak in agnostic
language.
If you get disconnected from me, you'll sound like the Antichrist.
Yes, sir.
Why do they have things similar? Well, because all three of them don't believe that Jesus Christ had any authority and power. His Bible's not real, and they reject him as their Lord and Savior.
Matter of fact,
Brother John declares in John, I believe chapter 3, he said, let me tell you something. In his spirit that confess that Jesus Christ is not the Son of God, he said, this is the spirit of the Antichrist.
Man.
There's only a certain type of person who would say that Jesus Christ is not the Son of God. And I don't know how nice they are, and how fun they are, and how good they are, how much money they gave you. If they don't believe that Jesus Christ is divine, if they don't stand that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, they'll never hear. And then in the life of somebody like you said, you're not going to be able to do anything in your life until you understand that I am the source and your resource, and without me, you can do nothing.
Man.
Tell the truth, stay in the church. There have been times in my life where I got disconnected, amen.
Uh-huh.
And you've been disconnected to me, and you said it twice, you had, you lying. And I'm going to tell you something. Just because you connected to something, don't mean you connected to him, amen.
Yeah.
Because sometimes you get some bad information, man. I don't know about it. There have been times when I have gotten upset, I disconnected from the mind, and stuff started to die. And when you live your life without Christ, I don't care what it is, how much money you got, I don't care how many girlfriends, boyfriends you got, I don't care what kind of hustle you got, when you live disconnected from Christ, you live a life ready to fail immediately because it's disconnected from what can make it last forever.
Man.
Just imagine, if you will, living a life without Christ. Who owns the air that you breathe?
God.
Who owns tomorrow?
God.
Who holds tomorrow?
God.
Living a life without Christ means that I play like a fool.
Uh-huh.
Imagine myself successful by knowing that I'm doomed from the very beginning.
Well.
Living a life without Christ means that I live my life almost in a state of ready to die, because as soon as the vine is cut, death begins to set in.
Ooh.
It may seem pretty at first, because when we were with Christ, things were pretty good, am I right?
Amen.
But when we got disconnected from Christ, we found ourselves slowly dying a painful and agonizing death. We used to pray all the time, but now we pray when somebody mentions us, it's time to pray. We used to sing in the privacy of our own home how good God is. And now we're on the same when we come to church. We're getting disconnected from the vine. We used to walk around looking for opportunities to tell people about Jesus, but now we're only talking about Jesus doing Bible classes.
Well. Preach it, brother.
Some of us don't even talk about Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Don't talk about him in your school. Don't talk about him on the bus. Don't talk about Jesus. But I'm going to tell you that Jeremiah said, I got to talk about Jesus. I got to, he's like fire. It's shut up in my bones.
Yes,
sir. I tried to hold it in, but I couldn't hold it. But it was burning and it was moving around. I had to say something. I couldn't hold myself.
Yes.
I had to tell him the quiet for he's worthy to be shouted.
Yes.
And she said, I see dead folk.
Yes.
First of all, she had to get out of my house. John chapter 15. He said, I'm a true vine. And he has seen the true vine because there's some fake vines that are out there. And I mentioned some of them as we started this text. I'm the true vine. Watch this. And then he says about being the husband in there, but every branch in me, now watch this, every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he taketh away. You're not just in the church to be in the church. You're in the church to be fruitful.
Amen.
To the kingdom of God.
Amen.
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 God didn't give us these cars just to be driving around to look pretty.
Uh-huh.
You have no business having transportation that don't lead folk to Christ.
Amen.
I hope God flip your car and flip you over into it. You're going to do something God will. Amen.
Amen.
When I examine my life and how I'm living, I look for the fruitfulness in my life to see if God's will and his blessing is moving in my life. And I just want you to stop just for a station identification just for a minute. When you look at your life, do you see the fruitfulness of the relationship you have with the Father?
Amen.
Some folks act like they come to church that they're doing God a favor. Act like that we ought to be glad that you're here. Let me tell you something very quickly. You can't do God a favor. You can't do God a favor. You can't beat God. You're not better than God. And all you is and all the stuff you're doing. If anything, you lucky God let you come to church in the first place. Amen. You lucky God let you listen to good gospel preaching in the first place. And you ought to do something with it. And the reason that your life is so bad is because you've been cut off from the vine.
Man.
Cut off from the vine, bleeding and dying. A soul death. Listen to this, because the Bible gives biblical dissertation concerning people who are living life without Christ. Ephesians chapter 2 and verse number 12, the Bible said that at that time ye were without who? Without Christ. It's not reading from y'all need the long version of that.
Oh,
Ephesians 2 and verse number 12, Alan, you can get for me. John, what would we say in the text? John 15 and 4, Acts 14, 22. But the Bible says in Ephesians 2 and verse number 12, it says that at that time you were what?
Without
Christ. Now I want you to understand, so there are some of you that are here right now that don't have Christ. There's some of you that don't have Christ. That's it right now. You haven't been baptized into the body of Christ, you don't have Christ. That's the name of said. But what's even worse is that those who have been baptized and still don't have Christ.
Amen.
Seriously, I mean, can I say this? If you're not going to come to the ecclesia, and I believe that I can say this, and God will stand behind me. You're not going to come to the house of God and make things better and show some respect for God and carry yourself like a relationship with God. Would you get the hell out of here? Would you get up and get out of here? Because it makes no sense for you to come here and try to do the devil's work in the house of God. There was a time when you were without God, your behavior was okay. But when you come into the house of God, you are connected to the vine. You ought to carry yourself with some kind of respect for the man of the house.
Yeah.
I am the true God, the husband. Yeah. The church is married to God. Yeah.
Yeah.
And when you come in his house, you ought to leave the bum life out of the street.
Amen.
When you come to the house of God, you ought to carry yourself like you know God is present with us. Folks are playing their way to hell and enjoying themselves and trying to take folk with them. And when God said his word in Matthew 23 and verse 5, that woe to you scribes and Pharisees, you church folk, you prepare the land and the sea to go about to make one Christian, one proselyte. And when he made twice the likely to go to hell, he's talking to folk who can physically show up and look like they're talking about church, but mentally do all kind of devil work and won't give God praise. I think it's just as nasty to sit up in the house of God and won't shout in there to say thank you, Jesus, or follow along the scripture than it is to live a life of prostitution the night before and don't come to church. I think it's just as bad. Then we gotta give God, we connect to the vine, we gotta give God praise and glory every chance we get, because the Spirit will feel the Spirit.
problems in church. Why are they praising God? Somebody got disconnected from the mind. And the sad part is that we're not talking folk outside the church. We're talking folks that's been baptized, their mama's been in the church, their dad's been in the church, their grandpa, their whole family in the church, and they still live like heathenistic dogs and don't care nothing about nobody but themselves. And I wonder sometimes why God just don't kill them right where they stand, because they respect and care about nothing but themselves. Yeah. Let these hellions walk around think they're doing somebody a favor when you ought to repent in the name of Jesus for the way you carry your disrespect to God and the vine that we all live in. Look at this text says, at that time, he was what? Without Christ. Yeah. What did I read? Were you doing without Christ?
At that time.
Without Christ, what?
Have you looked at what you've done by yourself up to this
If not Christ, who? If not Christ, who? You can't even help yourself around. Are you serious? If not Christ, then who? Paul said, as Luke records in Acts 14, verse 22, he declares that his word is in him that we move and breathe and have our very being. The times that life has been rough for me has been times when I left God's way and went about my own way. And I hear the Son and say, oh Lord, I know it's not in man to direct his own path. Yes. I know it's not, but there have been times when I tried to do it myself because it seemed faster and quicker and better, and I wound up on skin wrong every time. Right. Every friend that I lost with my God. Every enemy I gained them, not the Lord. Every trial that I've come upon, I have created those trials, not the Lord. In fact, I declare that when I failed myself, not because I was better, but because I refused to have a healthy relationship with the Lord. Amen. So he says, I'm the vine, ye are the branches. And I'm telling you that if you stay with me, then this is the good part, this is your I want you to cut out of this man. And some of y'all got some demons you've been talking to. And them demons have been whooping your butt every time you talk to them. You talk about hearing some voices in the head. What you hear, the demons. Some devils you need.